banana. Ba 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 banana. Yo, plano fou, la panneau no tout, ma banana, la camo pita la mo, banana, baba, ba, banana, potato, banana, tocali no potato, li cani, malo, manica, no tica, baba, ba, banana.
Sing. You guys love Jesus? How many of you guys know Jesus loves you? He never stops loving us. Jesus, our eyes are on you. We love you, God, but not nearly as much as you love us. Thank you for your love, Jesus. We just celebrate that this morning. Come on, lift it up.
Never stop loving us, no matter how far we run. You never give up on us, and all of heaven shouts, let the future begin. Oh, you never stop loving us, no matter how far we run. You never give up on us, and all of heaven shouts, let the future begin. Oh,
excited to have the kids upstairs with us. Hi, kids. Wave at me if you're a kid. Wave at me if you wish you were still a kid. All right. Come on, let's sing.
I'm coming back to the start, where you found me. I'm coming back to your heart. Now I surrender, take me. This is all I can bring.
You guys know how to clap? Go ahead and clap if you want to. I'm coming back.
I'm coming back to the start, where you found me. Coming back to your heart. it this morning. You never stop. You never stop loving us, no matter how far we run. You never give up on us.
For his love, you never stop.
You never stop loving us, no matter how far we run. You never give up on us.
For you, okay? All right, I think you guys know this song. All right, because of God's love, you know, how many of you guys know it changes us? God's light goes into us, and we begin to, kids, any idea what the word is? We begin to glow. All right, how many kids know the motions to glow? All right, if we have some brave kids in here, come on up. Come on up. I know you're dying to get out of your seats. Come on up. You can stand on the front of the stage or right in front of the stage. And you were right in here. Miss Brittany's coming to help. All right? So if you don't remember the motions, it's okay. Come on, girls. Come on. All right. You can be on the stage or in front of the stage, anywhere in here. And we're going to teach the adults. All the old people out there? Yeah, all them. Old people out there. There you go. Yeah. Right out there. Okay, we're going to show them the motions, okay? You guys remember it? You guys good? All right, make sure you got room. Make sure you got lots of room to do motions. You know how this song goes. It takes some energy. All right? Come on, remember?
Glow in me, won't you show in me all your glory, glory. Glow in the dark with your love in our hearts and we'll glow, and we'll
outside in the darkest night. Here we go.
In the darkest night.
In the darkest night.
In the brightest day.
In the brightest day.
You will be a light.
You will be our light.
Illuminate the way.
Illuminate the way.
So light it up, light it up, yeah. Light it up, light it up, yeah.
Stay up here just for a second, because I think you know the words to this, or the motions to this next one. Maybe we can teach them, okay?
Your love is deep. Your love is high. Your love is long. Your love is wide. Your love is deep. Your love is high. Your love is long. Love is deeper than my view of grace, higher than this worldly place, longer than this road I've traveled, wider than the gap you fill, deeper than my view of grace, higher than this worldly place, longer than this road I've traveled.
Job, you guys. Go ahead and have a seat. Let's give our kids a hand. Thanks for helping us out, guys. There you go. You guys can go ahead and go to your seats, okay? Go find Mama. great job, you guys. Let's get our eyes on Jesus. Let's keep singing the song, okay? His love is deep. His love is wide. There's no end to the love of Jesus. Come on, let's lift it up. Your love is deep. Your love is high. Sink in. Your love is deep. Your love is high. Your love is long. Your love is wide. Your love is deep. Your love is high. Your love is long. Your love is wide. Come on, lift it up. Love is deeper than my view. Higher than this worldly place, longer than this road I've traveled, wider than the gap you fill, deeper than my view of grace, higher than this worldly place, longer than this road I've traveled, wider than the gap you fill. Oh, your love is deep. Your love is. Beyond anything we could ever imagine. And your love never stops. Never stops chasing us, pursuing us. God, we thank you for your love. It's amazing, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God, we just celebrate your love this morning. We thank you for it, for your forgiveness, for your mercy. And all our mistakes, God, you are so good and so faithful. Thank you for that this morning. Our eyes are on you, Jesus. And as we get ready to look into your word, I pray that you'd speak to us, talk to our hearts, God. Help us grow. Help us know you more, Jesus. That's what we really want, God. We want to know you more. We want to walk with you closer than ever before. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Just tell Jesus thank you. Thank you, Jesus. I just tell him, thank him. Thank him for something specific. Think of something that you're thankful for. And just tell Jesus, thank you. God, thank you that you forgave me. God, thank you that you love me no matter what's going on. God, thank you that you helped me find my car keys. I don't know what, but just thank him. He's a good God. So Jesus, we remember your goodness, your faithfulness. We put our eyes on you, Jesus. We want to hear what you have to say, how you want to speak to us. So Jesus, our hearts are yours. This time that we have together is yours, God. We pray your blessing on it. In the powerful name of Jesus, everybody said, amen, amen, amen. All right, everybody grab a seat. Everybody find your seats. Kids, find your seats. There you go. All right, awesome. We've got a few things going on. And so, just a few, before we dive in, because we've got this craziness over here that's about to happen. Kids, you see this over here? Kids, anybody curious about these numbers and this giant dice over here? Oh, my. All right. We can't do that, though, until everybody's sitting down, find your spot, get ready to pay attention, because we're going to talk about some cool stuff. We've got a few things going on, and one of those things is movie night. This Wednesday night for youth. Movie night is Wednesday night, and excited about that. Wow, I wonder what all this is. Interesting. And so that's happening Wednesday along with ladies' Bible study happening downstairs this coming Wednesday. We've got a couple of interesting weeks coming up, but one thing that we we want to kick off ahead of time is, how many of you guys remember Christmas Blessing? Where we pick a family, one of our pastor families out in Bush, Alaska, out in the middle of nowhere, where it's really hard to get stuff, and they're serving Jesus out there and loving life, but it's got its challenges. So we pick a family each year and we bless them, and so it involves we hang out tags of all the items that you can purchase or money that you can give towards that project. That's going to be out there this coming week. And this coming Sunday, we'll have tags out there along with a sign-up sheet. And when you grab a tag, please sign up so we know who has what tags, where they're at, so we can follow up, check in. If you've got questions, we know what's going on. And so that is kicking off this coming week. We'll have more information on that. We're still getting the information on the family. And so that's coming up. And we'll have a couple weeks to be able to gather stuff, grab your tags, and bring stuff in over a 2 or 3 week period, and so we can get those boxed up and sent off. How many of you guys know mail can take a little while at times? So it'd be great to get Christmas boxes prior to Christmas. That would be awesome, right? All right, Linz, did we catch all that? Did we cover it all? All right. Sounds good. Forcibly, right? At gunpoint. We will take your gifts. Kind of like how you take an offering, right? We receive. Yes, we will receive the gifts for the Christmas blessing. And we will receive an offering if you're going to worship through giving this morning. You can give in the basket or the lockbox in the back, or online giving is available as well at mattnuskaag.org. All those platforms are available. And I believe board member John has an announcement. I prefer drummer John. You guys appreciate this guy? Can we give him a round of applause? I love this guy.
All right. Cecilia, could you come on up, please? Ed would normally do this, but he's not here. He got out of this somehow. Looks like cold or something to that effect. So, as you know, that a couple times here this last month, we offered discussed the announcement that it was Pastor Appreciation Month. And so in the month of October. So people gave, showed their appreciation for Pastor Shannon and Lindsay. And Cecilia's here with me. Obviously, Ed would be, but this is really from everyone here. We'd like to invite Lindsay up and Pastor Shannon here. And really, this is just an acknowledgement of how much we appreciate everything they do, all the multiple hats they wear, basically. Shannon wears a ton, and Lindsay is in the background doing a lot of things that probably we never even hear about, and I'm sure I never hear about. But anyway, Cecilia has this for you, a card for Shannon. Obviously, they're going to go and be gone for a week or two on vacation, or a well-deserved vacation. And so we just wanted to make sure everybody had a chance to participate this month. We appreciate everybody giving, and just want to give them a big hand, show them how much appreciation we have for them, please. Now, obviously, I don't see Mike, but Dieta, if you want to come up, come on up. She gets both anyway. It'll be good. It'll all be good. It's all legal. We do appreciate Dieta and Mike. They do a ton of stuff in support of Pastor Shannon. Groups, Wednesday night groups or whatever groups we have, they're always volunteering. Mike's always there counseling. We couldn't do it without them. And you guys have all helped bless them all. So please give them a round of applause. I wish Mike was here for it. So. We thank you guys so much. Appreciate it. And God bless you both.
Awesome. Thank you guys so much. And have really been blessed. There's been cards and things that have come in over the last couple weeks. Man, Lindsay and I just, we feel blessed. We feel honored. It's actually really special weekend for us. 10 years ago yesterday, we had the privilege and honor of being voted in as your pastor. And so like right around like 1:30 yesterday, it was like we changed decades here. And so this is the first Sunday of our second decade here. And so let the adventure continue. Let the adventure begin again. And we love you guys. So thankful for you. And it really is a privilege and an honor to serve here. And God's doing some amazing things. And so I know for everyone that's watching online later, I know we got a ton of people out. And everybody's all over the place or got the sniffles. And we know what that means these days. And so, you know, it's a good thing. Sniffles don't happen very often. Right? Just kidding. 10 days, start the clock, right? So we love you guys and are excited about this next season, whatever this next season holds. Kids, if over here is the past, right? Over here, this is what was the past, and then over here is the potential of the future. Where am I standing? In the present. Guess what? We always have the present. Even though it's not Christmas, we have the present. Right? We have right now. And right now is where we make our decisions. And so we look back over our past, and we try and learn from it, and we take information from it, and we become who we are through the past. And then we look forward at what is going to be in the future, and we take the next step. But we're always taking that next step in the present, and there's always past. There's always future, and we're always making decisions. And so as we look at, we're in a series called Sincerely Paul, where we've been looking at the book of Philippians. Everybody say Philippians. Now say it again because it's fun. Philippians, right? We like Philippians, right? Which is, Paul wrote a letter to the church in a place called Philippi. And this letter we've been looking at for the last 12 weeks. And we're going to look at this last chapter 4, the last of it. We're going to look at it all this week. Yeah, that's how we roll. It's going to be awesome. And the thing is you ever have a conversation with somebody and you're like, okay, I got to run. Oh, while I'm thinking about it, one last thing. And that one last thing is like six things, right? Oh, yeah. And then, oh, yeah, I forgot. And mom, don't forget milk. And chocolate. I want chocolate milk. And mom, and nighttime, moms, dads, nighttime. Oh, dad, I'm already out of the room. It doesn't count. You can't call me back in. Lights are off. Doors closed. Don't call me back. There's always like one more. And so Paul, as he's ending his letter, he has a whole bunch of things that he tackles that are just really, really good things. Really good things for us to remember. And I want us to remember as we head from the last 10 years into the next 10 years, as we head from yesterday into tomorrow, we want to follow Jesus. We want to know him more. We want to experience everything that God designed you for. All right? So as we look at this, I realized as I was prepping through this that not everybody knows Paul's story. So what we're going to do is we're going to watch a little video here that's going to tell the story of Paul. And even if you know the story of Paul, like the back of your hand, you may not have heard it told this way. This might be a little fun. Youth group people, same people that did the Zacchaeus story. All right? So one of these guys that is telling the story has a tendency to get a little sidetracked. So bear with him. He's going to get through it, and we're going to have some fun. Let's meet the Apostle Paul.
I'm Dan.
I'm Andrew.
And we're here to tell you a Bible story.
That's right. This is the story of a guy named Paul.
Well, actually, it starts with a guy named Saul.
Oh, so there's a different guy?
No, same guy.
So two guys, two names.
No, one guy, two names.
Wait, what? I'm super confused. My head hurts.
Here, let me show you what I mean. A long time ago, there lived a man named Saul.
Hey, he looks nice. What's up, Saul? Want to hang out sometime? Catch a movie? Grill some burgers?
I don't think you want to do that. Saul wasn't really a good guy.
What, did he like litter, double park all the time?
No. You see, Saul didn't believe in Jesus, and he hated anyone that did. He traveled around searching for anyone that followed Jesus, and if he found anyone, he'd throw them in jail.
Wowza, that's pretty rough. Looks like we're not hanging out anytime soon, Saul. No burgs for you, amigo.
But one day, something amazing happened. Jesus himself appeared to Saul.
Whoa, like the Jesus?
Yeah, man. Saul was traveling down the road when all of a sudden, a blinding light filled the sky and knocked Saul to the ground. Jesus called out to Saul and said, "Saul, why are you hurting the people that follow me?"
Oh man, I bet Saul was totally wigging out. Time to pay the bill, homie. Zabam! You just got straight up judged, son.
No. That's not what happened at all. Saul was so affected by Jesus showing up and talking to him that he did a total 180. He got born again, and he started following Jesus.
Hey, that's awesome.
And since he was a totally different person now, the first thing he did was change his name. He used to be Saul, but his new name was Paul.
Oh, so that's why there's two names in the story. Gotcha. Okay, that's really cool and all, but is that the whole story? I mean, it just seems kind of short.
No way. Paul's story is just getting started. After he got saved, he had a new mission. He would travel around preaching the good news about Jesus, healing people, starting churches, and getting people saved.
Yeah, way to go, Paul!
And after a while, he set a goal. There was one person in particular that Paul really wanted to share Jesus with. Someone that can make a huge impact if they were born again.
Batman.
What?
Yeah, dude, we gotta get that guy saved. Think how awesome that would be. Hey, it's time to take up the offering. Boom, $1 billion. Hey, I need to ride a church. Boom, Batmobile.
Okay, no, it wasn't Batman. Paul's goal was to share the good news with Caesar, the leader of Rome and the most powerful man in the whole world.
Whoa, that's cool.
But as he traveled around, he kind of ran into some problems.
You mean like he got stuck in traffic a bunch? Yeah, that construction will get you. It's brutal.
Not really. One day, Paul was preaching in a city when all of a sudden, an angry mob grabbed him, dragged him out of the city, and threw him in the dirt.
Whoa, why did they do that?
Well, even though Paul had totally changed, some other people still didn't want Jesus to be talked about. But that didn't stop Paul. He dusted himself off and he headed to the next city.
What happened there?
He started preaching, but again, some people wanted to shut him up. This time they grabbed him, beat him up, and threw him out of the city.
Again? Man, what did he do after that?
He picked himself up and he kept on going. He traveled all around the countryside telling people about Jesus, and he didn't let anything stop him.
And eventually everything started going smooth, right?
Not so much. People kept trying to stop Paul, but they couldn't. He just wouldn't quit. These people hated him so much that one time they waited for him by the gates of a city so they could catch him and kill him.
Good grief! What happened?
Some friends of his helped him escape by lowering him down the city walls in a basket.
Whew, that was a close call.
But in the next city, he wasn't so lucky. He was captured, beaten, and thrown into prison.
Wait, so he got thrown into jail for talking about Jesus? Oh, the irony. Well, I guess that's the end of the line, Paul.
Not so fast.
What are you talking about? He's in jail, dude. Game over, man. Game over.
Even in prison, Paul still shared the good news. He sang songs and praised God in his cell. He wasn't going to let anything stop him. And then that night, while he was praising God, something amazing happened.
He was up for parole.
No. A huge earthquake shook the entire prison. His chains broke and the doors rattled off their hinges. He was free!
Oh, awesome. So what happened after that?
He picked up right where he left off, and he headed off to the next city.
You gotta be kidding me. Okay, so obviously he's been through a lot, but surely things evened out after this. No more bad stuff, right?
Wrong. He was sailing across the sea when one day, a huge storm picked up. For days, the wind and waves pounded the boat until it crashed into a reef and started to sink. Paul jumped into the water and swam for the shore.
Whew, another close call. Just glad he made it to shore, glad he's finally safe.
Then he got bit by a snake.
What? Come on, man, are you serious?
While he was building a fire, a deadly viper latched onto his hand and it wouldn't let go.
Oh boy, well, it's been a good run, but looks like it's the end for Paul.
I don't think so. Paul just shook the snake into the fire and he wasn't hurt at all.
Unbelievable. Okay, I gotta know, how did he keep going when everything in the world was constantly against him?
Well, Paul knew that the power of God in him was way stronger than any of the bad stuff that came his way. With God on his side, he was unstoppable.
Man, Paul is like a real-life superhero. It's a bird, it's a plane, it's Super Paul!
You got that straight. And eventually, Paul accomplished his mission. He made it to Rome and was able to share Jesus with Caesar, the most powerful man in the world.
Mission accomplished. Man, Paul sounds like the coolest guy. Looks like we're back on for burgers in a movie, right, Paul? Big Paul! Paul-A! The Paulster! Paularino!
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm just trying out some nicknames for when Paul and I are best friends.
You know that Paul lived like 2,000 years ago, right?
Yes, of course I know that. I'm just gonna use my time machine.
Okay, for the last time, you cannot use your time machine.
Oh yeah? Try and stop me.
All right, that's the story of Paul, the end.
Oh man, really got me good there.
So that's our buddy Paul. And Paul, in one of those bunch of times where he got in trouble, when he was in prison, he actually wrote letters. And so he was encouraging people, teaching people, and affecting people from prison, from when he was, all these bad things were happening. And Paul wanted everybody that he came in contact with, he wanted them to know what he knew, right? That the power of God in him, power of God in you, is stronger than anything else out there. And that God loves you. And that knowing Jesus is the best possible thing that you'll ever experience in life. And so this is who wrote this letter. And we're going to come in and look at this last chapter, rapid fire. Super fast. Okay? But I'm not sure what order we should do it in. So I'm going to have our kids help me decide. All right? So what we've done is we've taken this chapter, and I'm going to look at this first verse, and then we're going to, we've got six parts of this chapter we're going to look at. Anybody ever play with dice? Yeah. How many sides are on a dice? How many? Six. Yes. So I'm thinking one for each of our parts. All right. So what's going to happen is let's look at this first verse, and this is gonna kind of open up this last chapter, chapter 4, verse 1. We're going to look at that. And for everybody that's been tracking with us throughout this series, you know that we've been picking a word that kind of defines where we're going. The word for this week is actually the first word in the verse. All right, we're going to go with therefore. Because how many guys know, sorry, I stole your thunder. How many guys know that when you see therefore in the Bible, you should probably check and see what it's there for? All right, so it's very important to know why it's there. So when you see a therefore, you got to check out what's before it. So that means that if you haven't been tracking with us for the last several weeks, you need to go back and check out the first three chapters to really know what Paul's talking about when he says, therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stay true to the Lord. I love you and long to see you, dear friends, for you are my joy and the crown I receive for my work. Stay true to the Lord. Stay with Jesus. Do everything he asks you to do. Trust him. Live life in Jesus. All right? Therefore is because of what Paul has talked about. He's just been talking about how amazing Jesus is. He's been talking about the life that we have in him. He's been talking about how because God loves us, we love other people. Right? It changes us. And so there's a lot that's going on, and Paul's saying, do it all. All right, stay true to God. Okay, now, as he moves on, what's going to happen, Miss Stacy, is we're going to have one of our kids come up and roll the dice, and whatever number comes up, we're going to reveal what's behind that number on the table, and then we're going to click the corresponding slide and see what passages, what part of the scripture we're going to look at, and what our word for that is that can help us remember, okay? So I need a volunteer to roll a dice. Come on up, buddy. Big man, bring it on. All right, come on up. Think you can handle this? Or do you need a partner? Need a friend? Yeah, I think you got it. It's a little heavy. You ready? You ready to roll it? Okay, let's roll it and see where it goes. Ready? Go for it. Oh, nice. One. Good. Five. Nice job. All right, let's go ahead and lift up one. There you go. And what's under there? What is that? Is that a remote? Nice job. Boom. You go ahead and grab a seat. Let's give him a hand. Nice job. Remote. Remote control. I can't believe we got one on the first one. We're apparently just going to go straight through this. All right, we're gonna hold off on the next one. Okay, I'll call for volunteers as soon as it's time, okay? Remote is our first one. Let's go. Moving on to verse 2, okay? So we're just going to go straight from verse 1 to verse 2. All right, our word, come on. Except you got to say it right. You got to say, come on! And if you want to, you can add man. That actually works really well. Come on, man! Come on! All right, let's read what it is. Let's see what Paul says. You ready? Now, I appeal to, these are weird words that you'll see in different translations, different way. Yodia, Suntuche is actually probably how you pronounce that in Greek, but please, all right, so these two ladies. Please, because you belong to the Lord, settle your disagreement. Everybody say disagreement. Kids, you know what a disagreement is? You don't agree, you disagree. Very good, very good. It's like an argument, right? Right? You're not agreeing, right? Settle your disagreement. Stop arguing. You can almost hear Paul going, come on, right? And I ask you, my true partner, to help, this is somebody he's writing to, right? To help these two women, for they worked hard with me in telling others the good news. They worked along with Clement and the rest of my co-workers, whose names are written in the book of life. I don't know if there's ever been a device that has created more arguments than a TV remote. Anybody else argue over what you're going to watch? Anybody else? Or who gets to control it? How about volume? Volume, people? How many times we're going to switch between TV shows? Right? I just picture all three of my girls sitting on the couch going, well, she picked the last one, and then she picked the next one, and it's my turn to pick. And we went through three rotations, but now it's my turn. And I just, and the remote just passed back and forth. It's amazing how the little things like grab all of our attention. It's like we can make it through an earthquake, okay? Right? We can make it through an economic collapse and all come together. But you take my remote, we're done. This is something I noticed, that sometimes the big things, look at what's the big thing in here, right? They worked hard with me telling others the good news. They were telling people about Jesus. They were affecting eternity. They were dedicating their lives to changing the lives of others. That's a really big thing. It's an expensive thing for your life. It costs a lot. It's hard. It's a lot of work, right? There's a lot of other things they chose not to do because they wanted to do this one really, really big thing. But then they have this other disagreement. They're fighting and squabbling about something. And you see Paul, you know, he's going, come on. Come on, you guys know the big stuff. You guys know what's really important. Stop fighting about the little stuff. You know? You can go through and tap your knee with a chainsaw. How's Mike doing, by the way? Beautiful scar, yeah. You can go through like some pretty intense injuries and just kind of breathe through it and just go through, and then you like stub your toe in the middle of the night and like your world comes unglued. You know, or the worst, what annoys me the most is when I'm walking in the middle of the night and like someone leaves the closet door open and it hits right here and it doesn't move. It's like it hits you back. I'm convinced it like it's like a firing pin or something, and because you're not expecting, there's just something that just seems unjust about the entire situation, and you just want to throw down. And sometimes it's the little things, but come on, Let's focus on what's really, really big and not let the little things trip us up. Okay, kids, let's not fight about the little stuff. Let's think about what really matters, right? And now that's something that we learn as we grow up more and more. Sometimes us grown-ups need to learn a whole lot more still, right? Because we get caught up on the little things too. But this is Paul saying, come on! Remote. Next time you hold the remote, remember, let's not fight about the little things. Let's keep focused on what's important. That makes sense? All right, so everybody say, come on! All right, I need another volunteer. Ooh, I saw you first. Come on up. You ready? Okay, let's go ahead and roll it. Yeah, that way, as hard as you can. Boom! Wow, dead on six. Love it. All right, you ready? Oh, this is a cool one. Go ahead and pull that off. All right, now step over to the side just for a second, because I think there's a lot of people that recognize what this is and are looking forward to it coming back. Raise your hand if you know what this is. Oh, here. Come on over here. Let's stand right over here so they can see it. Raise your hand if you know what it is. Okay. Very cool. We obviously have a collection of trophies here. Nice job. Thanks. You can go ahead and grab a seat. Nice job. Going to number six. All right, here is, we have the trophy that was given out for our last ladies scavenger hunt. And I'm sure we are excited to be able to hopefully bring this back this coming summer. Would that be awesome? All right, so we've got an award for the ladies scavenger hunt. We have another award from the Hotel Casino Vegas. We'll ignore that. We're redeeming this award. We have another award. I just bought it at Bishop's Attic. It's the youth award that we actually fill with lots of stuff. Airheads. Okay. Here's one for movie buff. Very nice. I award this to my wife, Lindsay, especially if it involves classics. Okay, awards. Almost had something else up there. Almost had thank you notes. All right, we're going to down to number six. Our word is celebration, going down to verse 15 of chapter 4. Okay? Celebration. You never notice that trophies, a lot of times they have something printed on them, right? Because a trophy isn't just a trophy. It's like we're not getting a trophy for decor. I mean, usually. Some people do, but that's a little weird. Right? We get a trophy for something. Okay? I got a couple trophies when I was in fourth and fifth grade, I think. I played Parks and Rec basketball. And I think it was fourth and fifth grade. And I was a part of the same team 2 years in a row, the Runnin' Rebels. Right? And the first year, they gave us a trophy at the end of the season that proudly said, 0-7. We lost with grace. The next year, we came back. We had worked out all summer. You know, we were doing the whole carbo-loading thing and protein powder. And I was in fifth grade. No. So we came back, but somehow we got a trophy at the end of that year that said, 7-0. Clean sweep. All right, so they were recognizing what happened. The Runnin' Rebels, Coach Matt, just came back to me this week, and I was just like, oh, I missed that. That was awkwardly cool. Learning how to play basketball. Celebration, okay? So the idea of trophies. Let's see what Paul says. It says, starting in verse 15, as you know, you Philippians, right, the people who lived in Philippi that were part of this church that Paul is writing the letter to, were the only ones who gave me financial help when I first brought you the good news and then traveled on from Macedonia. Okay, guys, remember Buddy Barrel? That's what he's talking about. He's talking about money that was given to missions to support him on his missionary journey, just like Buddy Barrel. Even when I was in Thessalonica, you sent help more than once. I don't say this because I want a gift from you. Rather, I want you to receive a reward for your kindness. All right? He's telling them, thank you so much for giving. And I'm not telling you thank you because I want to get something from you. He's like, I want you to know that I appreciate it. Verse 18, at the moment I have all I need and more. I am generously supplied with the gifts you sent me with Epaphroditus. You guys remember Epaphroditus? Ditto. They are a sweet-smelling sacrifice that is acceptable and pleasing to God. And this same God who takes care of me will supply all your needs from his glorious riches, which have been given to us in Christ Jesus. So what is he saying? Really, he's saying thank you. And he's not saying a generic thank you. He is celebrating the good that has been done. Everybody say celebration. All right, you guys know what celebration is? Right? Like a birthday party is a celebration. What are you celebrating in a birthday party? Hanukkah, right? Oh, no, that's not it. What are we celebrating at a birthday party? A birthday, yes. Yes, all birthdays or one birthday? Somebody's birthday, whoever the party is for, right? We're celebrating something. We're calling it out. We're making it known. We're saying, this is awesome. This has happened and it shall be recognized, right? I wanted to look at three things that Paul says in this part. What is he celebrating? How is he celebrating? Look at these three words, right? Supplied, sacrifice, and supply again. Supplied, sacrifice, and supply. What's he saying? Right? With supplied, he's saying, you blessed me. Look, I have all that I need. I've got plenty because of what you sent. What's he doing? He's recognizing the fact that you changed my life. You made my life better. You did something good, and I am being affected by it. One of the ways that we can celebrate and say thank you and be and impact the people around us, kids, is we can tell people how they helped us. You can say, thank you, Mom. I really like this breakfast. Right? Thank you for picking me up. Thank you for that I don't have to walk to school uphill both ways the way you did in the snow. Right? Supplied. Paul says that I've been generously supplied. In other words, you gave me what I needed. Okay, you blessed me. And then he says sacrifice, right? A sacrifice that is acceptable and pleasing to God. He's saying, when you gave to me, you blessed God. What you did mattered to God, and it was a good thing. He's calling it out. He's encouraging them. He's celebrating them. And then supply. What does he say? The God will supply all your needs. Not only am I blessed, and you blessed God, but I want you to be blessed. I want good things to come to you, right? This is how we celebrate. This is how we call out good things. There is good in life, therefore, celebrate, right? So many of the good things that are in our life, so many of the toys we got for our birthday, so many of the toys we got for Christmas, we forget to celebrate. We forget to recognize that they're there. We forget to say thank you for them. So many of the good things that happen, the clothes that we're wearing, right? The kind word that was just spoken to us. And we just let it go. We got to celebrate these things. We got to recognize them. We got to say thank you. We got to say what you did matters to me. All right? Does that sound good? Let's celebrate things. If we're going to follow Jesus because of all he has done for us, we got to celebrate things. Right? We're going to avoid the little things, the little come on moments. And we're going to celebrate the good stuff. All right? Celebration, makes sense? All right, celebration. Oh. All right, moving on. I need another roller. I'm going to go back row. Come on up, Sid. Where's it going to land? Who knows? I don't know. Come on over. Let's see what we're going to do next. All right, toss it over there. Ooh, a reverse spin. Oh, number six. Let's do it again. Try it again. There we go. Good spin. Yes, nice. Ooh, number three. Okay, let's pull up number three, see what it is. Let's get this out of here. Oh, what is that? Telephone. telephone with a cord, a landline, people. Nice job. Go grab a seat. Landline, hello? Yes, I'll wait. Anybody? Okay, you guys remember this as a kid? Just a second. Hold on. Just a second. My phone came off the wall. Yes, I'm back. Just a second. I got to type in the phone card number. I've got some more minutes. Lindsay and I, when I was in college, we'd burn through those 1,200-minute phone cards like they were nothing. The good old days. A landline, telephone. What's our word going to be? Number three? Conversation. Let's go to number three, which is verses six. Whoop. How many guys are phone chatters? Yeah? I don't think I saw my mom half of my childhood. I just saw the little phone cord going around the corner. Not really. We had a cordless at that point. All right, conversation. Verse 6. It says, don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Everybody say pray. All right, pray. Everybody know what praying is? Talking to Jesus, listening to Jesus. Then you will experience God's peace. Or pray about everything. Tell God what you need. Thank him for all he has done. Then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds, is more than anything we can understand. His peace will guard your hearts and minds as you live in Christ Jesus. It's going to keep your mind and your heart safe. If we do what? If we pray, right? If we have a constant conversation with Jesus. Here's the thing. When Jesus died on the cross, when he paid for our sin, the line was open. Use it. Jesus is sitting there, call waiting. Little elevator music is playing. Just waiting for you to pick up. There's a constant open line of communication with God. What's Paul saying? Pray about the important things. Right? Pray at church. Pray in severe emergencies only. Pray always about everything. Talk to Jesus about everything. Never hang up. Because you know what? Jesus never hangs up. He is always there. The line is always open. And God says that if we talk to him about everything, it will guard our hearts. It will guard our minds and what we think about. Anybody ever have bad thoughts? Yeah? Anybody ever feel bad stuff inside where it feels like your heart's heavy or dirty or sad or scared? Guess what? Paul's saying talk to Jesus about it. Talk to Jesus about everything. And his peace, no matter what's going on, peace doesn't mean that it's boring. Peace doesn't mean that nothing's happening. Peace means that there's something deep, 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 deep inside of you that's solid, that's confident, that's not scared, that feels loved, that feels cared for, that knows that God is holding you, he's protecting you, he's got you, all right? And so if we continually talk to Jesus, not only can we learn and grow from him and with him, but there's this relationship and there's this presence. We're never alone. It's amazing. Never stop talking to Jesus. Never shut down the conversation with God. The line is always open. He's never going to hang up, okay? Everybody say, conversation.
Conversation.
All right. The cross opened the line, so use it. All right, we ready for I need another roller. Oh, I saw that big hand right there. Right behind. Actually, we've only got a couple more. Do you want to bring your sister up? You guys can see how far you can throw it together. No? Okay. We'll do a couple doubles. Ready? All right, see what you got. Boom! Yes, I love it. 5. I can't believe we're getting all these open numbers. Okay, this is a cool one. See what's behind there. What is it? A plant, yeah. What's it? Any idea what it's made out of? It is. It's a metal tree. Nice job. Just bump. Oh, yeah. Okay. Very cool. This, look at this little tree. Isn't that cool? It was made by my grandpa. Isn't that cool? Before he passed away. Because it would have been weird if it was after. But this is a little metal tree. And it's very cool. And so, but number 5, we've got, our word is confidence, okay? And another word that we can say with that is, I can, okay? Say that with me, I can. Okay, everybody, I can. One more time, really loud, I can. Okay, I can, let's read this. All right, confidence, number 5, starting in verse 10. It says, how I praise the Lord that you are concerned about me again. Right, he's talking about them sending gifts and wanting to take care of him and all that good stuff that the church cares about Paul. Right, I know you have always been concerned for me, but you didn't have the chance to help me. Right, they wanted help, but they couldn't be there because Paul was in another part of the country. Not that I was ever in need. I have learned how to be content with whatever I have. I know how to live on almost nothing or with everything. I have learned the secret of living in every situation, whether it is with a full stomach, every tetrarch stomach, full stomach, right, or empty, with plenty or little. Verse 13, for I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength. Even so, you have done well to share with me in my present difficulty. Okay? So, the reason I have a tree behind here is the I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength makes us feel like we're superheroes. If I have Jesus, I can make things float, right? If I have Jesus, I can get A's on all my tests without studying because I can do all things through scriptures taken out of context, right? I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Guess what? It's not that I can do all of the things I want to do. I can do whatever Jesus wants me to do because he gives me strength, right? I can't accomplish my will and what I want, but anything Jesus asks me to do, I can do. Look at a tree, right? A tree can, it's incredible how an apple tree can make apples, right? But it's so disappointing how an apple tree can't help me with my math homework, right? In fact, it can't even give me peaches. But they look so close. I dare you, ask a tree to help you with your homework. All right, go ahead, see if he's any help. Because a tree can't do that. Doesn't even want to try. What's a tree going to do? A tree is going to produce the fruit that God created for it to produce. Guess what? You have things that you are supposed to do. You have things that God is calling you to do, wants you to do. You were created to do these things, and you can do all of those things through Christ who gives you strength. We can't do all this other stuff over here and the stuff over here that we want to do or we wish we could do over here. That's not what Paul's talking about. Paul was going through some really tough stuff, right? Remember the video? Right, he was getting chased out of towns, and he was doing everything that God asked him to do, and he was doing it through all this crazy hard stuff. But he could do it all because I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Anything that God has designed and created you to do, you can do. You can have confidence that I can do it because God gives you strength. All right? Where's your confidence level that no matter what comes tomorrow, you can handle it with Jesus? That's what Paul's saying. Whatever comes, no matter how great it is, no matter how hard it is, whatever tomorrow holds, you can handle it because God's strength is in you. All right? It's the promise. We're not going to do whatever it is that comes into our head that we want to do, but anything God asks us to do, we can do it. We have confidence. Everybody say, I can. I can. All right. So what do we have left? We've only got two left. Okay. So I need one more roller, and let's see if, actually, you and you. Let's do a team roll. Come on up. Come on, Harp. Come on, Ellie. There it is. That was a big roll last time. Okay. All right, we're going to do a team roll. Here you guys, come on over here. You on this side? Go ahead and you on that side. Harper over on this side. And we're going to count to three. And you guys are going to roll it as far as you can that way. Ready? Yeah, I'm going to go one, two, three, roll. Okay, ready? Yeah, we're just going to chuck it. Okay, ready? One, two, three, roll. That was intense. All right, that was a four. We got a four left. You guys did it. Nice job. Let's go ahead and reveal both of these. Okay? Harper, grab one. You grab one. Okay. There you go. There's that one and that one. Nice job. All right. What's this? Crazy string. Interesting. What's this? Cup. And what do we think our moms and dads might put in this in the morning? Coffee cup. Go ahead and grab a seat, girls. Nice job. Thank you so much. Silly, crazy string. Gotta love crazy string. Number four. Our word is concentration. Number four is our beloved coffee mug. Concentration. Right? Now, I am not going to try and argue the benefits or lack of benefits of coffee affecting concentration in our lives. I will leave that for you to battle. Concentration. Number eight, or verse eight. It says, and now, dear brothers and sisters, one final thing. Fix your thoughts on what is true and honorable and right and pure and lovely and admirable. Think about these things that are excellent, worthy of praise. Keep putting into practice all you learned and received from me, everything you heard from me, saw me doing. Then the God of peace will be with you. All right? Fix your thoughts. Concentrate. Everybody know what concentrate means? Show me a concentrating face. Oh, yeah. I see a lot of concentrating going on. And some napping. But that's okay. It's another form of concentration. Right? Concentrate. Fix your thoughts. Fix your eyes. What you look at, what you take in, what you think about. Right, think about things, and he gives this whole list of good things. Right, remember we talked about sometimes our mind, we think bad thoughts. Sometimes we feel bad things in our heart. Right, how many times has that happened after you watched something on TV? Right, or read something, or saw a movie, or somebody told you a story, or something like that, and it just started these ideas that you didn't like. Right, these thoughts. Yeah. Yeah, I think we've all experienced that. It's very important what we think about, what we choose to fix our thoughts on, to concentrate on, right? We concentrate on school. We also need to concentrate on good things. How does Jesus feel about you as opposed to how do your friends feel about you, right? What we choose to fix our thoughts on, what we concentrate on, it's got to be good stuff, right? Now, whether it involves coffee or not, I'll leave that up to you. But we gotta think through, concentrate on what was Paul concentrating on. If you look in the chapter right before, therefore, right, everything else is garbage compared to knowing Christ. That's his focus. That's what Paul wanted. That's what we need. That's the opportunity that we have, because Jesus is the best thing in the entire universe. Therefore, concentrate on him. Okay? And then our last thing, concentration. And then what's our last thing? Oh, man. Crazy. Crazy string. Which is what number? Number two? Let's go back up to verse 4 and 5. It says to shake it. I don't know why. All right. Go back up to verse 4, our word, consideration. Okay, now that's kind of a weird word. Boys and girls, consider. Just means think about, right? Think about. If I'm being considerate, I'm thinking about other people, right? If I'm considering something, then I'm like making a decision. Like if I'm considering this cap and does it fit this thing, I'm thinking about, does it fit? Yes, it fits, right? If I'm considerate, you know, if I'm not considerate, what's happening? I'm not thinking, you know, I really don't care what people think about me. And Crazy String just has one of those things that's just, it's a little messy. And if I wasn't thinking, you know, I probably would not spray. Oh my. But if I was considerate, I wouldn't do that. You know, I Yeah, it's one of those. Okay, no, just kidding. Right? Consideration is, I think about how it's going to affect other people. Right? I'm thinking about what my decisions, how they impact people around me. Right? And so, I was cleaning it and it went off. Okay, verse 2. Always be full of joy in the Lord. I say it again. Rejoice. Everybody say rejoice. Let everyone see that you are considerate in all that you do. Remember, the Lord is coming soon. Jesus thought about you, so think about other people. Right? Right in the middle, there's this joy that we have. We rejoice because God loves us. He's taking care of us. And so because Jesus is taking care of me, that frees me up. I don't have to take care of me nearly as much as I think I do. I can take care of John. Right? And then John can take care of Tim. Right? And we can take care of each other because we're already taken care of by God. So we don't have to fight for ourselves, which is usually what happens to, you know, what leads us into number one. Right? If we feel like we have to fight for ourselves, then I'm going to fight you for the remote. And we're going to fight about the little things because I care about me. But because Jesus cares about me, we can watch Paw Patrol. It's okay. All right? Consideration. That all makes sense? Jesus thought about us. We think about others. Here's some ideas that Paul has just given us. And now we're going to go down to verse 20. And this is how Paul signs off from the Philippians with the church in Philippi. It says, "Now all glory to God, our Father, forever and ever. Amen. Give my greetings to each of God's holy people." Tell everybody I said hi, right? "All who belong to Christ Jesus, the brothers who are here with me send you their greetings." The guys all say hi, right? We do this on the phone a lot, right? "And all the rest of God's people send you greetings too, especially those in Caesar's household." And then verse 23, and this is where I want to leave us off this morning. "May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit." This is how Paul ends the letter. And so over this last chapter, what are the six things we looked at? Right? Come on. Everybody say, come on. Everybody say, come on, man. Right? Don't fight over the little stuff. Remember what's important. Consideration, because Jesus took care of us. We can take care of other people. Conversation, don't hang up on God. Right? Always talk to Jesus. Keep that conversation going. Concentration, think about good things. Confidence. How confident are you that because of the power of God inside you, you can handle anything that comes your way? Right? He's got you. He'll take care of you. He'll carry you through. So no matter what happens at school tomorrow, no matter what happens at work tomorrow, no matter the unseen thing or the thing that you're in the middle of right now that feels like it's overwhelming, whatever it is, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Everybody say, I can. I can. And celebration. That might be my favorite one. Celebration. There is good in your life recognize it, celebrate it. Don't let it go unrecognized, right? Celebrate it. Tell people thank you. Tell them how what they did affected you. Tell them how what they did blessed God, and want the best for other people. Celebrate them. All right, I invite everybody to stand. Kind of a different service this morning, kind of fun. I love having the kids upstairs with us. You guys did a great job rolling those dice, by the way. Nicely done. That was some impressive rolling, I must say. All right, I can't believe we only had like one repeat, didn't we? Right? We had one. You guys rolled through all six numbers in seven tries. That's impressive. I know. Yeah, I think maybe that was the secret. But as we sign off, as Paul signs off with the church in Philippi, and we're signing off this morning, I know Lindsay and I are getting ready to, we're going to be out the next couple weeks. I'm excited. Right now, Pastor Mike is slated for this coming Sunday, unless travel interrupts that. That's the plan. And then I'm really excited for you guys. My old boss, Pastor Jack Aiken, is going to be filling in the pastor slot on the 14th. And so he's coming out from Eagle River, and he's going to be meeting with you guys, sharing with you guys. So I'm excited for that. And then I'll be back the following week. But Pastor Mike's going to be preaching then as well. And so we're just going to be getting back into town and getting rolling. And I think it's the 31st. Happy Reformation Day. I think this is the last of fall. I'm excited, people. I mean, I am like literally catching myself from starting Christmas playlists. I just nope, not yet, not yet. I'm really bummed. I'm gonna miss the first Christmas song on the radio while we're out of town. Oh, I like stay up at night and try and figure out, you know, is Delilah playing it? Is it in the midnight changeover? When's the first song and the last song? I gotta listen to the last song too. But anyway, it's coming. It's okay. It's 40 degrees, blowing windy rain. There's no more leaves. You know, it's okay. Let it go. Let it go. Embrace the holiday season and whatever it is that comes next. I'm excited for what God has for this church. I'm excited for not the winter season, but the season of ministry that we're experiencing together as the family of God. And so I just want to pray over us. And I pray this, same thing Paul prays, that as we head out today, I pray that his grace will be with your spirit. And as we move forward and we stay in conversation with God, we stay concentrated on good things, right? We're celebrating things. You know, we're avoiding those little come on moments, you know, and we're going to move forward. We're going to see all that God has in store for us. And so I just want to pray that over us as we close this morning. And Jesus, we love you, God. I thank you for your plans in store for every person here and every person watching online. Jesus, I thank you for our kids that got to spend today up here with us. I thank you for the energy, God, the imagination, the giftings that you've placed in their life, how you've created them with purpose. And Jesus, I just pray blessing over them as they're growing up and they're growing in their relationship with you, God. Over all of us, God, I just pray for more of you. God, we want more of you. God, everything else has no value without you. So, Jesus, we place you at the center, God. I pray that your grace would be with our spirit in whatever it is that we're facing, whatever it is we're walking through, whatever it is you've called us to. Jesus, there's purpose in it. And, God, I thank you for that. We pray for the steps ahead, whatever they may hold, God. We place them in your hands. We trust you with it. And, God, I pray that your kingdom would come and your will would be done through all of our lives as we say yes to you, as we know you more, as we rejoice in what you have already done for us. And we rejoice, God, in how you love us and you're drawing us close. So, God, I pray we would walk close with you as we leave this place. Bring us back here safely once again, and we give it all to you. In the powerful name of Jesus, everybody said, amen, amen. Nice job. Love you guys. Don't forget youth movie night Wednesday night, ladies Bible study Wednesday night. Not as exciting, but still very, very important and very good. Probably doesn't involve popcorn, but, and then we've got, Christmas blessing stuff coming. More information on that. Love you guys. Have a great week.